Come on now, let's put our hands together, sing that song, Pick Me Up From the Miry Clay. Come on, put your hands. Pick me up from the miry clay. Put me on the rock to stay. Can I hear your voice? Pick me up. Wonderful. Put me up. One more time. Yeah. Pick me. Put me on the rock to stay. Oh, my love was in a mess. I thought there's no way out. He is the rock, Jesus is the rock. He is the rock on whom I stand. Oh, He is the rock, Jesus is my rock. Come on, rock to stay. Pick me up from the miry clay. Pick me on the rock to stay. One more time, pick me louder. Praise the Lord. How many of you know this song? Never, 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 never give up, okay? Can you put your hands together louder and sing so we feel good, okay? Never, 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 never give up. If you can believe it will be done. Yeah. good in the midst of hopelessness. Yeah, don't you ever give up.
Come on, come on.
Never, 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 never give up, friend. Stand up and just a little worship. Little worship. I worship you, O Prince of Peace. That is what I want to do. I give you praise, for you my righteousness. I worship you, O mighty God. There is none like you. I worship you, God. Yes, there is none like you. I worship you, O Prince of Peace. There is what I want to do. There is none like you, Majesty, worship His Majesty unto Jesus, unto Jesus. Kingdom, kingdom, authority flow from His throne unto His own. His anthem ring, so exalt us, so of Jesus. Jesus would die. Time glorified, King of all kings. Jesus would die. Jesus died, now glorified, King of all kings. I will give you all my praise.
Lord, I will give you, Lord.
I will give you all my worship. I will give you all my praise. You alone I long to worship. You alone.
Alone we long to give all our worship and praise, for you deserve the glory. You alone are magnified, Lord. We magnify your holy presence, Lord. Oh Lord, you alone be magnified, Lord. One more time, just lift up your hands and say, Lord, be glorified, be magnified in my life, Lord. Lord, there is nothing else I'm looking for. We want to see you lifted up, Father. Yes, Father.
Be magnified, oh Lord. You are highly exalted, and there's nothing you can't do.
Just sing with me.
Be magnified, oh Lord.
You are high.
You are highly exalted. There is nothing
God. I'm sure you're very happy this morning. Amen. Praise the Lord. There are three things. Very comfortable. Thank you. Lovely. Okay. There are three things I want to share today, which are very crucial in our lives. Easy, right? To remember three things. But in those three things, there may be a few things you need to extra note it. Please note it in your mobile phone. avoiding the temptation to go and check messages. That's, you know, dear big people. See, sometimes people don't allow you to even look at a mobile phone, but it's better you note something than note nothing at all. Are you with me? Those small notes that you make will help you. Otherwise, you listen, and go. In a year, maybe 52 messages and still don't know anything. Can happen, correct? Let's be practical. If you ask me what I preached 3 weeks back, I struggled to recollect it because in between I preached few messages somewhere else. So this is human limitations. What do you say? So if you write it, scribble somewhere. So you must bring your Bible, bring a notebook. I'm not trying to teach you, treat you like a kid, but I'm treating you so that you will become great people. Okay? You must be great people. You must scribble something. Otherwise, no, we don't have the stuff to retain. Our memory is limited. You need an extended memory like a notebook to scribble and keep it. That's also you can refer any time. Because this is about value, about life and coming up. So you will really enjoy it, but if you don't apply, then you don't benefit. Okay, number one, you see, we know we are all made up of three components of the spirit, soul, and body. Okay, I don't need to go through that again. Now, how do we see great things happen in our life, and how do we handle, if you call it like a machine, no, you know how to use it, how do I make things happen beautiful in my life? Are you with me? Okay. Yes. See, now I must keep track of the time. Okay. You say 9, 10, 15, 20. Okay. So I'm having 30 minutes or a little more than this. Yes. Okay. 10, 20, right? Okay, fine. Thank you. I wanted to do that. Thanks. Okay. Thank you. My dear pastor friend, amen. Such a joy whenever Thompson calls me. I'm always there. I would love to be there unless I'm elsewhere, okay? So my friend, let us think. How many of you are looking for a miracle in your life? All of us, correct? Yes, that is normal. Not because we are sick and handicapped and useless and forsaken, no. For us to go one more step higher in life, it needs a miracle. If not for you, for who else the Lord is going to do? Correct? But it takes two hands to make a noise. With one hand you cannot. So God is there for you, but God cannot do without our cooperation. What would I say? We need to align with Him. We need to cooperate. Then you get the job done. Otherwise, you'll be just doing like this. That's all. So it's sometimes we throw all the responsibility on God. And we call it God's grace. And all those things are nice to hear, but it'll never work. You can pray for 40 years and still be the same. Okay? So that's where the frustration can come. I've been a Christian so many years. Yes, you've been a Christian so many years, but you need to do things right. But there's always a right way of doing, there's a wrong way of doing. So you need to learn how to do it. How? Because we have the Word of God. The Word of God is so clear to educate us. So now you see how God has created so many things in our life to be a blessed person. I only wish I could go through everything one shot full speed. Like three messages together, I'm going to put together. Okay, so God has given us a mouth. Okay, so when I ask people, for you to have a miracle, what should you do? People say, pray, have faith. Everything they say, everything is good. But I tell you, your mouth is very, very crucial in your miracle. Okay? How? Because many times we don't realize. We always think pastor will pray, somebody will pray, some holy man from somewhere will come and pray for me, things will change. I don't want you to be deceived, okay? There are instant miracles that can happen. But you can create your world beautiful, and God has given it to you. And God created you like Him. Like Him means there are many factors. One of the factors is God can speak things and you can speak. He's given a mouth, okay? A lot of things he has imparted to make us like him in the way he can decide, he can feel, he can take decisions, he can analyze, he can be so rational. All he's given to us. What for? You don't know. But God gave you the ability to speak. The animals don't speak. They don't speak, correct? I don't know. If you're an animal lover, you may say, yes, he speaks, I can hear it in my sleep or something. But that is extreme, okay. But what I'm saying is, to speak something into existence, that God has given the power. So that is why when we are going through difficult times, if you're going through difficulty, if you're going through a heartache, heart attack is different, heartache. If you're going through problems in your home, financial, and you're crushed, at that time, you must be careful what? To guard your mouth. Why? We are always used to explain our problems, the negative things immediately. When you keep on talking negative things that are happening in your life, it can only reinforce it and give more strength for it to thrive in your life. Are you with me? So what does God say? Let the weak say. Now that means you don't tell your problem, no? You're telling the answer and the thing that you're looking for. Are you with me? So there is a major decision to change your mouth. But always, as human beings, when somebody asks, we want to tell our sad stories, we want to tell how much nobody in the world can understand what I'm going through, and you really hunting for a little self pity party. This is how people have. Let's accept it. But that will never benefit us. We don't need anybody's pity. Are you with me? Hallelujah, I like that. So God doesn't want us to spew negative things, because negative things will create negative things to happen more in our lives. So what we should do, let the weak say I'm strong, let the poor say I'm rich. He's beautifully told that. And now you must guard your mouth, because your mouth can create an environment for a miracle or an environment for no miracle. Are you with me? See, are you enjoying what I'm saying? Does it make sense? Are you taking notes maybe? I don't know. So number one, guard your mouth. Guard what you say, because it's so powerful. Because the Bible says in Proverbs, it says in 18:21, what does it say? Because death and life are in the power of the tongue. That means in your mouth, what is there? Death and keep moving with me, because don't get stuck searching for a, just listen, move. Death, because you want the Bible verse, okay. Proverbs 18:21. Okay, that's why I said you need a piece of paper, write it and move with me. By the time you dig, I'm gone. So now what has happened is, what is in your mouth? It's like I give you two paints, one black, one white. Now what are you going to do with that? You want to paint your house black, it's left to you. How will your house look if it's all black, ceiling, wall, everything? I would love to use it as a photo studio maybe, but not to live there. But if you want your house to look nice, you will paint what color? White. Then it's bright. Okay, are you with me? So the same thing in your mouth, you know, negative words like black, white is positive words. What are positive words? There are so many promises that God has given you. But if you don't spend time to write those promises in a piece of paper or mark or memorize, then you will be left without words. Okay, so you must take God's promises. God's promises. So the mouth will talk about the promises. It will speak loud. It must speak loud and bold. Okay. Now you see, when David was addressing Goliath, he was very loud. He was talking loud to him, very bold. He says, I'm going to kill you and take your head off, man, and feed your body to the fowls in the air, birds. He told that, and his confidence. So when you see that, this mouth is very, very powerful. Mouth is a weapon. So in the mouth, it's like a launching pad, like a gun. What kind of bullets you will put? It's the word of God. It's the word of God. The promises of God are very important. So God has given us a mouth to create. So if I will only tell you in a short time, your words can create your world. What did I say? Your words can create your world. Your world can be so nasty, but God has given your mouth to change the nasty world into a beautiful world. That's how he is. See, I'm not joking. I'm serious. No, see, listen to me. There was a valley of dry bone. So when the valley of dry bone was there, bones that not even skeleton. Skeleton will have a structure. This is like a junkyard. You don't know. This one, that one, something all put together. And God says, tells a prophet, what does he say? He doesn't tell him to pray. Many of us would have gone and prayed and shouted so much that we couldn't speak more. Voice box gone. But God said, go and prophesy. God says, go and prophesy means go and tell what I tell. I tell you one means you go and tell one. That is foretell. Go and go forth and tell what I tell you. And I tell you, and then when he spoke, addressing to the bones, flesh came. Nerves came. Everything came. Finally, they became what? Army. Just imagining a dry bone without hope. What a shift. Your life, you can paint your life with your words from black to white. From dead, dry bones to a beautiful army. That is useless to an assert. Your life can change, brother, but it's life is in your mouth. How you speak. They are seeds, what you sow. You sow weeds, then that's what you reap. So today, ask yourself, what kind of words I've been speaking about my mother, my father, my family, and all negative? Or are you a person leaning towards self-pity that you need a healing? I'm telling you, you need a healing. The Holy Ghost can heal your hurts. There are people who have hurt you, their words, the way they've treated you, they've spoken, they've disappointed you. Now our heart is crushed. You may have a crushed heart here. You may have a wounded heart. You may have a broken heart. You may be having a bleeding heart. And you alone know the oozing pain of your life. Nobody knows, but the Holy Ghost knows. And he's teaching you, you have to help yourself. You can't go to anybody for that help. And God says, I made it such a way, I've given you a beautiful mouth. And that beautiful mouth must be put to use. And I tell you, do it yourself. DIY, people have so many. So you have to do it yourself. So that is why you see, this mouth is very important. Now my mouth, how it will operate, whatever is in your heart only, the mouth will speak. That's what the Bible says. The abundance of the heart, the mouth will speak. The mouth cannot speak what is not there. So what is there? So much of negativity in this world. We talk a lot of nonsense, what other nonsense people have told, not even checking whether there is a bit of truth in it. Correct? And it's a fashion to talk about it, but that's how the media and magazines will put thoughts into you. And you'll talk as if you're a great scientist. You never even went and saw whether it's right or wrong. But we keep talking. You know, this is what is happening in the world. Come on, you learned it somewhere from some fellow who told something, and you'd never even checked the validity of it. And you keep talking, 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 and people think you're a very knowledgeable person. Such talking people are the people who are in poor condition, financially and in their life, because they are believing more of lies than the truth. They don't dig the Bible to find the truth. They adopt a lot of falsehood that the media and other people have told. And that's why people are scared. They are very much on the edge, fearing they will die. What does the Bible say? I will not die, but I will live and declare the works of God. Now you choose life. You want to choose lie, then you go by that. But if you want to choose, you be a counter trend and you tell yourself and you look forward for a beautiful future. We need to look forward for a beautiful stuff happening. So how is your mouth? Are you a person who curses? Cursing is a fashion for someone. Hey, I want to tell you, whatever you come so far in life is nothing. There's much beautiful things yet to see. Don't blame your mother. Don't blame your father. Don't blame anybody. If I need to blame people, if I need to get sorry, if I need to get sad, just like anybody else, we have 101 reasons to feel sorry. But we decide, though it can be true, but we don't want to accommodate that. Why? It'll kill me. Bitterness will kill you. Are you? Just imagine a boy cheated you. And you, 2 years back story, okay. Now you want to keep thinking about it. He'll be happy with another girlfriend, okay? But you are in a sorrow boat. You're sorrowful. And that is affecting your memory, mind and studies and focus and your appetite and your look, radiance is gone. Now, whose fault is this? Your fault. Because everybody can do anything and go away. But it's you who allow them to ruin your life by thinking on that. By holding on to that. Holding on to the past happenings. Holding on to what people have told. What parents have told. Now that is where your emotional heart health must arise. Whatever people say, let them say. But I'm going my way and God is with me. Huh? Though I walk through the valley of shadow of death, I fear no evil. Nothing will touch me because the Lord is with me. Now, number two, very important thing is people must know. What they must know is there is something called the eye of the heart. Yesterday I was preaching in my Zoom meeting. Every Saturday I do, I told you in English. So the eye of the heart. Because God created us with the eye in the heart. That is, you can see in the spirit. When the Holy Spirit will be poured on the last days, my youth will, what they will start to see visions, the elderly old people's dreams, this is in the spiritual realm, he will open your eyes to see those things. Are you with me? I'll tell you, that's a beautiful verse, I need to take you to that. Ephesians 1:18. Can somebody read for me? Ephesians 1:18. Later I will read for you from Amplified. Can somebody who's got a loud mouth, a loud sound, okay, voice, can read it for me? Ephesians 1:18. Okay, now it's talk of eyes of the heart, eyes of the understanding. Now you got that, no, that Bible verse? Okay, what is that Bible verse? Ephesians 1:18. Go home, meditate, read different translations. Okay. Another, it says the understanding. Okay. The Greek word, I don't want to go into it and just talk something which I'm not a student of Greek, so I leave that. Okay. The Passion Translation says, I pray that the light of God will illuminate the eyes of your imagination. See, Passion Translation says, eye of the heart, amplified. Then another version says, eye of the understanding. Okay. Understanding. It's talking about the understanding. Okay. Now all these things you put together is telling you'll illuminate the eyes of your imagination. Now, do you know the heart has got, the heart means the core of your being, which is the spirit part of it, no? It's got an ability to imagine. So if they say you got to imagine it, see, this has been abused. People talk about visualization, okay? Visualization is trying to create pictures in your mind and imagine the eyes of your understanding, the place where you can imagine everything is there. So the New Age people do it, the occult, the witchcraft, all kinds of people do. Because they do it, there are a lot of counterfeits that doesn't disqualify the original. Okay? Are you with me? Are you with me? Yes. Jesus always spoke in imagery. Correct. David prayed, the Lord is my what? What picture comes to you? Lambs are there, sheep there, and the shepherd is there. Like that, my God is. See, a lot of things, his prayer, everything. And Jesus was mostly speaking a lot of parables. And then there are pictures. They appeal to your imagination. Okay? And they stick to you. Okay. Now, all these things are there. But what is wrong with it, you must know before you go to the right. The wrong part of it is, if a man or a woman chooses what he or she wants to picture and visualize, then that is wrong. You want to picture something on your own. Now some people make it as a trick. Sit down and just picture, see that the girl opposite to your house is coming into your house. She's asking you to take her on the motorbike. Wow. Man, this is not what the Bible says, okay? You're abusing. And that's where people go into, you know, covetousness. Some people go covet people's houses, their cars. No, we shouldn't go. You must know certain things are not allowed by the Bible. If you would go into that, this will cause a lot of disqualification. You make fouls. That is, you lose the game. We don't do cheating. We don't speak lies. No, all these things will kill us. I'll talk to you later. one day about speaking lies and living a dubious life and being deceptive. All these things Christians need to hear, because a lot of Christians grown in churches are suppressed and they like to act and they give one picture but they are another face to it. So hypocrites. Hypocrites cannot come from outside. Hypocrites can only be coming from church, because they know the truth, they act, but they are not living that. Are you with me? Character. So it includes me and you. See, we are not here criticizing anybody. We are just telling, hey, we need to be careful, man. We are very nicely groomed, everything. We come from good family, so we know how to act. When pastor say, hi, pastor, praise the Lord, pastor, last week was fantastic, pastor. It was not fantastic, but still we try to be very positive. But it goes on like this, telling stories. No. See, I'm not telling. See, if you come, how are you? You will say, praise God, things not bad, I'm good. Nothing wrong. You can't be telling all your sad stories to people and they won't come to your church, because full of crazy people. No. So what you'll say, church, how fine, okay. That's not a big lie. But I'm talking about really lying. There are things which we don't think, but keep lying to your parents, lying to your mother, lying to your wife, lying to your husband, lying, speaking lies to everybody else and even to God. Are you with me? It becomes very normal. Especially in families, when parents are liars, children take it easy. And that becomes the nature of life. No. Your yes must be yes. No must be no. There's nothing in between. Are you with me? Your yes must be yes. No must be no. Otherwise, what do you become? Little deceptive. Little kind of a deception is nothing else but lie. Lie is nothing but from the father of lies, the devil himself. Why should we become little cousins to the devil? Come on. Reasonable, right? Are you with me? Yes. So, people speak lies. Why? Because they are number one cowards. You're scared. Why should you be scared? We have prepared ourselves even to a level when you say, are you a Christian? Yes, I'm a Christian. You want to behead me? It's okay. But at another wink of the eye, I'll be with them in another kingdom. So I don't need to be a chicken, I'm a lion. When you have this concept, you don't speak lies, because you are not a coward. But the Bible says in Revelation, cowards will never enter. Do you know that, sister, brother? You're only telling the opposite lady, and that guy is a womanizer, he will go to hell. I want to tell you, you will be welcoming him into the hell. You will be there first for if you're a liar. Am I taking the truth? Let's understand. Let's not deceive ourselves. We are walking in the light. We don't want any darkness in our life. Now, where I'm trying to tell is, see, God works through people in the area of imagination. Why? I'll tell you. So, as I told you, that part of your imagination is very powerful, because God uses that. You have to use, for example, you take Abraham, when he sends the servant to go find a girl for his son, he's telling, sir, I go, but if the girl doesn't come, what will I do? Very nice, right? So what does he say? You turn with me to Genesis 15:6. Okay? So God gave Abraham a wish, not that one, sorry. This one is also, you can talk about Abraham. I'll come to that. Before that, God took him out of the tent to see the stars. And he said, like this, your generation will be, you can't count them, innumerable. So after he said that, he gave a promise, okay? He gave a promise and he gave a picture. Now listen, what does God do? He gives a promise. Repeat again. He gives a promise and he gives a picture. To whom all? Many guys. Because he gives a promise and a picture, that's why you go on dreaming on your own some things or not. Real divine meditations are meditations based on God's promises. God tells you you're healed. And then you picture yourself as if you're healed. God says, I'm going to bless you. He told him, I will bless you, but it took 25 years for a child to be born. So in the meantime of 25 years, what can he hold on to? The picture, he closes his eyes. He recollects the number of stars I can't count, the sand I cannot count. So many grandchildren are going to come when he didn't even have a cradle in his house. You may be right now in a situation, but your God is telling, I'm going to take you from where you are to a glorious time. Some of you always remember, you'll be married to a very good person. Because people can't even think like that. Because they say, my auntie messed up her marriage, my mother messed up the marriage. So, 2 + 2 = 4 is not a mathematics with God. They can mess, she can mess, but you can choose not to miss the right person. Prepare yourself, be like a princess and a queen, and prove that you are blessed by God in front of everyone. But if you're going to go by their logic, then it's going to be following that. But here, God is telling, I'll give you a vision when you pray in your spirit. See, that's why the Bible says, meditate on God's word. When you meditate on God's word, listen, you will picturize it. When God says he's clothed you with the righteousness like a robe, if you only memorize the scripture, it's one kind. But if you just close your eyes and look at and imagine that you're wearing a robe, and the robe is God's righteousness. And when you walk, heaven can recognize you're wearing that. It's the righteousness of God. Imagine yourself wearing a robe. Wow, that sticks to you in your mind. So, see, that's why you see the people, how they operated. Like Abraham, I told you like this. Abraham, what did he do? He took two ingredients that God is using. He gives a promise, he gives a picture. He gives a promise to Jacob. I'm going to give back. When you come back, you'll all this land, you will see that. When he's sleeping, he sees a ladder. Angel come, angel go. On top, God is standing there and telling, this is how I bless. Now the picture and the promise is associated. That's the power of associating things, no? For example, no, most of the Bible verses were not written. They were sung. With a tune, it's easy to remember, correct? Without the tune, it's difficult. Like that, God is locking with a picture his promises. The same thing happened to Joseph. Joseph, two dreams. The second dream is still more intense. He's telling the sun and the moon, that are parents, and the 11 stars, the brothers, they will give you that worship, or they will do the obeisance, or they will respect you and bow down. And it happened. But for him to remember through all the ups and downs, going in the pit, forsaken, falsely accused, in the prison, he still could hold on to what God had shown. I will be lifted up, man. I don't belong here, but I'm coming out. Because the picture and the promise. Are you with me, sir? So this promise, now we can, God is inside, in us, abiding in us. So how much more we can imagine? So for that imagine, you see, I'll take you to one of the beautiful things. You must remember in Psalm 16:8. Okay, everybody turn to this. Please, I'll wait till you take. Psalm, where do you find Psalm? Just divide your Bible into equal halves and you'll find it, okay? So Psalm, what does it say? Somebody read it. Okay, now you see, what does it say? I have set the Lord always before me at the right hand. So because he's there, I will not be moved. Another translation, what does it say? When David walked, no, he pictured the Lord on his right hand. He always pictured. He imagined God is on his right, so nobody can move me. Do you think David was so powerful? One of the elements is this strength of what he believed and what he pictured. I'll give you another translation or another scripture, Acts 2:25. The same thing. The same Bible verse, you see, I would say, Acts, the book of Acts, you turn to chapter 2, verse 25. For David speaketh concerning him, what does it read? I foresaw the Lord. Now listen, foresaw. That one, it says, that guy has set him there. That means he has pictured God always on. Here it says, he foresaw, he made an attempt to foresee. What do you foresee? Do you always foresee God is with you? God is in you? God is walking with you? See, Abraham beautifully says, that's what I want to tell earlier. But he said, no, when Abraham was telling the servant to go there, he was asking, if I go and the girl doesn't come, what I do? That you'll see in Genesis 37. And he said unto them, here I pray, this is what has happened, all what has happened. What does he say in Genesis? I think I didn't tell you the correct verse. Okay. Genesis 24:38. Okay. In 24:38, what is this talking about? It's the consciousness of the God's presence is because he put a picture on his mind. He is able to see. What does he say? You know, verse 40. Genesis 24:40. See, when the guy said, no, if they don't come, boss, what will you hold me? Then he says, no, the Lord before whom I walk. Now imagine, sir, every day, the Lord before whom I walk. This is how Elijah, when he introduced, who is Elijah? How does Elijah introduce himself in the Bible? I am so and so who stands before the Lord. Wow. If you are a person who stands before the Lord, all human beings must bow to you. That's how God will elevate. Don't have a very poor, sorry image about yourself. No. You stand before God always. No, I stand before God. God is always on my right side. You know, there was a man of God, when he prayed, he always had a chair, empty chair. He imagined God is there and he talked to him. Wow, he's not a mad guy. See, what is the quality of our prayer? How much time we do take to meditate, even when you're simply sitting at home, you're not talking about your problems, who you are. My friend, now, I tell you, when you talk about anything, you and I need to only talk about the greatness of God, not the magnitude of your problem. Are you with me? So when you're sitting here imagining the greatness of God, God is your friend. More than that, God is your father. Papa, you're the child, joint heir, bought by the blood, and you are with him. This consciousness, like how Abraham was conscious, David was conscious in the Old Testament. Now when we have him right inside, we need to be conscious. And this happens in the area of imagination. Are you with me? Now, what's the time? Oh, I have another four minutes. Okay. Now, I'm going to finish it. A very important thing. This, if I don't tell, my whole message is a waste. Now, because the area of imagination is where God puts picture, and the picture slowly will manifest. Even after 25 years, the baby Isaac was born. So, the area of imagination can be misused. See, in the days of Noah, the Bible says their imagination was constantly evil. So now people say, don't see this, don't see that. Now come to a point. My God and I are going to interact in the area of imagination, so I must keep it holy. Are you with me, sister? Sometimes we take it easy. What big deal? We watch this, we watch that, we watch everything. And finally, the imagination, the spirit part is corrupted. And the tuning knob is broken. You're unable to tune with God. Because you're always tuning to something else and got stuck. Their imagination has been constantly evil. Just ask yourself, have we gone through that? I have been evil. I must accept that. That's why I boldly talk to you. I know what is to have a corrupted mind, dirty mind, imagination spoiled. Why do I say that? I don't want you to feel you're the greatest sinner and I'm the holiest person. No. I'm coming to you from that angle telling, hey, I know what is that junk. But I tell you, when you have those junk and we still say, sorry, sorry, God, and take communion and go and we develop weakness in our life. I want to tell you, be serious today. I've told you not like great man telling, I'm telling you like a friend. We have tasted the worst side of life, okay? And still we are not taking off. What should be the reason? The reason is, ask yourself, what you put in front of your eye will reflect into the eyes of your heart. So, you want to come up in life with only the help of God. I tell you, your pastor can't help you much. I can't help you. Your father can't help you. The government can't help you. You have to help yourself. So you must be desperate for God. The desperate for God is, God, how can I make that area that you cannot come, Lord? Because he is holy. So tell God my imaginations, what are the junk that I put? It's only like acid and poison to kill me. But I don't want to die. I want to achieve and do things. My health must come. My wisdom must come. My sharpness must come. I must become like Esther. I must become like David. I must become like Abraham. That means all these fellows had their eye of their heart opened, enlightened, not darkened. Don't allow the world to darken that area so that you can't see and you lose. An orphan girl can become a queen. A shepherd boy who was kept there, you know why? Because he was an illegitimate child, not part of the family. So he was kept outside. But God saw that guy and he says, I need your heart. I need your eyes. You are a wonderful man. You please me. Not all these fantastic looking guys. And David was taken. That's why he says, no, my mother conceived me in sin. When my father's children and my mother's children, both of them rejected me. There's a Bible verse. He had a siblings through that way. These guys and those guys. But my God picked me. When my father and mother, they gave up. The father never invited him when the selection was going to happen. When Samuel came to choose a king from the family, he was excluded. But God made it to happen. The guy couldn't sit down until they brought him. See, my friend, God will promote you. What is your faithfulness? Learn from Joseph. If you will leave your home and go to a hostel, what kind of a person you or me will turn? We know our weakness. We know our appetite. We know what we like. What is forbidden is juicy. Okay. But this man was out of his home. But how did he carry himself? He says, when the woman is trying to tempt him every day, not one day, every day, he says, how can I sin against my God and your husband who has trusted? Look at the way, look at that integrity, look at that desire for holiness. He says, even if you throw me in the prison, it's okay. But I don't want to be nice to you so that you'll promote me. No, I want to be nice to God. My friend, today make up your mind. Your way to go higher is based on your mouth, is based on your heart. Imagining, picture, all those things are not on the evil, but it's biblical, I showed you. Now, what is going to happen is that, how is that screen when everything is put there? Beautiful, huh? Songs. You have a screen there, right? How do you, when the songs are put, how... It's so beautiful or not? You can see my picture there. Look at it now. Just now, if I take a paint, black paint, and spray on top of that and tear it apart, what kind of image will be there? That's how it will happen to your heart. Don't allow the devil to tear it and scar it and make you focus on, and you make a commitment with God. You know, Job was a very old man during Abraham's time. What does he say? I made a covenant not to see. What see? Keep my eyes on a woman or something. I don't want to keep watching, looking 2-3 times. That's me. And I want to tell you, there's no way, shortcut, secret. There's a straight cut. You and the Lord make a deal. And miracles happen. I tell you. You are about to get married, the guy will come searching for you. More than what you thought or expected, more brilliant things God has got in store for you. In your insecurity, don't go and fall in some pit. In your life, keep yourself a deal with God. Don't allow the people whom you love to, you know, make you unholy. We all have been unholy, correct? You ask your pastor, he will also say, we all know what is unholiness. We've eaten the pig's food. But that's the time God gives us mind changes and we come towards the Papa. Papa's waiting with the arms open. There's a great future for us. So where God wants to interact and he wants to speak to you through dreams, keep that nice. And you'll get connected with God. And then your heart will be filled. Number three, which I wanted to share, maybe 1 minute I'll share. Because you must keep your heart joyful. The state of your mood is joyful. Are you a moody person? You are not okay. You are not sick. But what I'm trying to say is, you must make up your mind that you will become yet I will praise person. That is, whatever happens, I'll be happy, joyful in the Lord. This is very crucial. Your mouth, your heart, your imagination, and the mood is joyful, not sorrowful, bitter, cribbing, murmuring, you're out. You don't need the devil. You're good enough to kill yourself, ruin your life. So how happy are you? Though the fig tree may not, I will rejoice. I will sing a song, hallelujah, because the concept of the confidence, God is with me. Even if I don't have a dad, my heavenly dad is there. If I don't have money, the money will come. Because God will command the ravens, God will command the widows, and those things will come to my doorstep. Because God is a God who works behind my back. Amen. He works in the back. You're seen. He's working on your behalf. So have the confidence and all the time keep thanking Him. You don't need to have something happen then thank. No, simply thank. When things are happening bad, also thank God that you are with me. I'm still not dead and you have got a great future for me. My friends, if you will align these things, your life will be brilliant. Okay, let's sum it up. Four things or three things I told. What? First, I was talking to you to guard your, because out of it will flow life or death. Okay, and then I told. Then the second thing I told you is the guard your heart with all diligence. Out of it flows the issues of life. In the heart, the eye, and imagination. And then I said, Noah's time, imagination was totally evil. Okay. Then the third one, little bit I told you, is joy. Joy. Keep yourself joyful. At least just put on Laurel Hardy movie and watch. I'm telling you, it'll work. At least laugh. But never get into murmuring, sadness, negativity. You have a great future. The Lord loves all of you. Amen. Every single person, He loves you. Because you have done mistakes in your life, that will never disqualify you. Because Papa will never disown you. He died for you. Even He died for you, sir. You would have come first time. But I want to tell you, Jesus, with His arms open, He says, come. I will bless you. I will prosper you. Turn away from everything. And now understand, pursue after what will bless you. Don't pursue after the enemies. Things that will destroy you. Make a commitment today. Shall we bow down our heads? Father, we thank you. We thank you for the beautiful, lovely God who loves us so much. And also, Father, I thank you, Father, for you have taught us. So we have to keep our heart clean. And we must try to always pursue, because that is where you will connect, Lord. That is where the good water is coming. We don't allow drainage to go through that. No. So we yield ourselves, continue to do a deep work and draw us close to you and bless us. Help us to paint our life beautiful by our words, not negativity, not to dwell on sadness, Father. Keep a joyful spirit and make us a blessing. We love you. You are there for us. What more we need, Lord? We don't need anything else. When you are there, we have everything. So we love you. Just open your mouth and say, Lord, I love you. Lord, I love you, Lord. What more I need, Lord? You're more than enough. Lord, we love you. Thank you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Wasn't it wonderful? Why don't we all clap hands once again and bless Him for coming and ministering to us, for all who come along with Him. And thank God for leading us and for His word. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for giving us your word and teaching us and showing us from your Bible how we need to live our life. Pray that you'll bless dear Brother Isaac Joe and his family and his ministry team. Pray that you lead and guide. Cover, O Lord, with your blood and your name, O Master. Pray that each and every one who come here this morning, they will take care of all their needs and bless them abundantly. Give you all the praise, glory, and honor and power for all that you've done in our midst. In Jesus' mighty name, I ask and pray. Amen.